Hello everyone, welcome to another End of the Void Real Review. This time we are reviewing Ferrari, a biopic on the life of Enzo Ferrari as a father, husband, and visionary behind the car manufacturer Ferrari. Adam Driver drives this movie confidently in the title role with an assuredness that is both compelling and riveting. You get to see Enzo's personal life and professional in equal measure that keeps you invested throughout the movie. However, I have to say that Penelope Cruz probably steals the show as Laura Ferrari, the wife of Enzo. She's a firecracker in her role as a spurned woman who does things with a directness that is fierce in execution. She steals every scene she's in. She's that good. It's fundamentally imperative that Driver and Cruz have such great performances because they do carry the movie through the slower parts. Actually, I couldn't help but see that. You notice that Driver and Cruz, both their names have racing connotations. I just couldn't resist. I had to point that out. There are some gruesome scenes that do take place when things go wrong behind the wheel. There are a couple times I audibly gasped when things went sideways. There are some truly impressive shots behind the wheel of the early prototype cars of Ferrari's beginnings. Last year, Gran Turismo had some epic crash scenes, but in Ferrari, they're on another level. Remember, these cars were ultra lightweight back in the early days, and it didn't take much to make these things crumple like paper mache and send drivers flying when hitting something on the road, or worse yet, hitting another car. And Enzo had many detractors like Maserati who were too eager to sabotage him, making the race car drivers as well as any spectators on the sidelines unfortunate collateral damage to whatever booby traps they had in store on the racetrack. It was truly horrific stuff, and Ferrari doesn't pull any punches when depicting this. I didn't research if this is historically accurate, but it has happened before in race car drivers where, you know, spectators have gotten hurt or killed. So, as a whole, I imagine it's true. Race car driving is definitely dangerous, and there's a newfound respect of what these people do when taking part in racing, in whatever sense it may be. When things aren't happening on the racetrack, things are happening in Enzo's personal life that threaten his legacy, which I won't spoil here. Let's just say things get just as heated in Enzo's family life as it does on the tarmac. The story isn't anything we haven't heard before, as in any other biopic on an iconic figure. These people tend to struggle to balance work and familial relationships. There is something to be said about the bigger you are, the greater drama you can spawn. That is the cost of building a legacy, and that's what Ferrari did, for better or for worse. The mistakes he made in his personal and even his professional life definitely threatened to destroy his legacy, and the movie explores that. I recommend giving Ferrari a test drive even if you're not into car racing. Your mileage may vary, no pun intended again, depending on how much you care about the subject matter. The pacing is kind of slow in the beginning and then accelerates smoothly from then on. The things that happen in the movie are more interesting with Adam Driver driving the scenes forward. Penelope Cruz makes the movie cruise with her anguished and spirited performance. Sorry, I couldn't resist. I give Ferrari a 7 out of 10. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.